The last part of section 1.8, the fourth part, is about graphing circles. I'm hoping at this point that you guys appreciate the smaller portions of the sections here and see the value in it. If you have to go back and review the material at all, that'll help you break it up a little bit more, but it does feel a little longer this way. But we want to talk about circles. Some of you may not be very familiar with circles. If we want to think of the circle and all the points on it, what's true about them? Well, they all have a set distance from the origin, or from the center, I mean. So we're going to draw a circle as best as we can. Oh, not a bad circle. Draw a line from the center to a point on the circle. Let's say we go over here. Well, we know that this distance is the radius of the circle, but let's say that instead of being at the origin, we're somewhere out here on the coordinate plane. And so we're going to call this center HK, and that's just kind of a standard. I'm honestly not real sure where it came from. The H is horizontal, makes sense. I'm not sure about the K, but in this point, we're going to call XY. Then how do we calculate the distance between them? Well, that's supposed to be R. We can use kind of our distance formula to calculate it, or just think about the Pythagorean theorem. So we know that X minus H squared plus Y minus K squared is equal to R squared. There's our equation for our circle. I'll write that down again. This is our generic equation for a circle whose center is located at a point that we're going to label HK, and that has a radius of R. Well, if the center is 0, 0, then this simplifies. Then we have x squared all by itself because it's just minus 0. We have y squared equals r squared. And that's the example that we had looked at in the previous portion. Example 4 says we want to graph the equation x minus 2 squared plus x plus 4 squared equals 36. Let's think about the generic formula x minus h squared. So h squared. So h is 2 plus y minus k squared. Well, we don't have a minus, we have a plus. So what does that mean? Well, that means that k is actually negative 4. And lastly, it's supposed to be equal to r squared. What is 36 a square of? Well, that's 6, so r is 6. So that means that we put our center at an x value of 2, a y value of negative 4. Oops, I didn't do a very good job with this graph. Let's go on to another page. I went on to another page because I didn't really give myself enough room there. So, oops, it was supposed to be positive 2. Positive 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4. That is still negative 2, but there's our center. Our radius is 6, so we go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the top of our circle. And then we're going to go over 1, so it's 4, 6, all the way over to 8. And I'm going to do my best. And that's. See how rough my circles are? So, what do you think I expect of you? Pretty much the same. On your tests or anything. So, our radius here is 6, and our center is at the point 2, negative 4. Just label those things, and I'm happy. Of course, if you're doing it on WebAssign, they have really nice drawing tools, so you'll be able to draw that nice and pretty. Well, what if we have to find the equation of a circle? So let's say we're given a couple of points. Can we find it? Or if we know the radius and center, we can use the equation that we already had. If not, we have to find them. And we're going to find them by using the distance and midpoint formulas. So we're going to find the equation of a circle that has the points 1, 8, and a different point is 3, negative 6. And these are end points of a diameter. So a diameter goes straight across the circle. It goes from in whatever shape. I was going to start drawing it, but that's actually not where that radius is, because it goes from 1, 8, now that's somewhere up here, to 3, negative 6, so it's a little complicated. But here's our radius does go across. So what do we need? If we need the center, we need the midpoint between these two things, and if we need the radius, we need half the distance. So we need the distance and midpoint formulas. So the distance between P and Q, remember that formula? The square root of the differences in their x's, so 3 minus 1 squared, plus the differences in their y's, negative 6 minus 8 squared. So that gets us the square root of 2 squared is 4. Negative 6 minus 8 is a negative 14, and we're going to square that. Well, you may not know that right off. I just went ahead and did that off to the side a second there. And that turns out 14 squared is 196. So plus 4 is 200. Well, I don't like the square root of 200, but that's okay because we don't really need that. This is equal to the radius. But when we write the equation for the circle, we're going to square that. So that'll be all right. Now we need to find the midpoint. And remember that midpoint between them is actually going to be our center. So we'll just label it that way. Our center, we average the x's, so add them together and divide by 2, and average the y's, add them together, divide by 2. So what do we get? We get 4 divided by 2, which is 2. And what do we get here? 2 divided by 2, so we get 1. So our center is at 2, 1. Our radius was the square root of 200. So our equation of our circle is x minus h, here that's 2, plus y minus k, in this case that's 1, equals r squared. Well, what's the square of the square root of 200? That's 200. And there's our equation of our circle.